Thank you. All I ask is to look and feel beautiful for one day. Sure, I know those books that talk about if you're beautiful on the inside, you're beautiful on the outside. My family and friends tell me similar notions, but honestly, let's face it, I'm an ugly duckling. Though I've tried just about everything under the sun that I could possibly get my hands on. You name virtually any damn woman's care product, and I either tried it or I read about it. Nothing seems to make me feel like a beautiful woman. Some days I look at those women in movies like Julia Roberts or Audrey Hepburn, just real classy women, beautiful women. I sometimes wish I were them. If I could be beautiful on the outside for a day, that would be my dream come true. Just for one day to see what it feels like. To be able to look in the mirror and like what I see. To be able to get compliments and date men for a change. That would be my beautiful day.
Amazing work, Sophia. I can tell you've really connected with this piece. Because this is a religion class, I just have a really quick question before we move forward. What drew you to this monologue amid our discussion of morality?
Well, as a teenage girl, my worth is often defined by what I can provide to the world as a woman. Since the day I was born, I've been taught by society and influenced heavily by the media to think that my worth lies in whether or not I am desirable enough to be married and have children. This piece describes the pressure women face to be desirable in order to find love and contribute to society. In this piece, the character describes her beauty as a crutch to bear in life. That's how I feel about the societal pressures I face every day.
I think we've come a long way from the traditional gender roles in our society. I'm really sorry to hear that you still feel this way.
Yes, I think in certain ways we have moved from that stereotype. However, even within the Catholic Church, many of our foundations are based on the idea of woman playing the role of the caregiver. The Catholic Church encourages the idea of family, community, and participation, and the importance of marriage and family, but also preaches the importance of an organized society helping all its members grow as individuals. I sometimes question the caregiving role women are given in our society that is encouraged by the church and how it may stunt our growth as individuals. As a young woman, I aspire to work and travel and create, but I sometimes feel as though I'm boxed in by this idea of women being caregivers. I wonder sometimes if it's possible for me to have both.
We teach you that women should be caregivers and loving motherly figures to give an example to the rest of the world, such as Mother Mary or Mother Teresa. In this day and age, it will be possible to have both because you're given the freedom to find your place in this world. You have a right to participate in society, seeking stable and strong relationships in order to give back to this earth.
I totally get where you're coming from. I mean, for me, growing up as a woman of color, I was constantly defeminized, and it was always made clear to me that I was perceived as extremely masculine.
Tell us more about that, Susie.
Well, whenever I would turn on the TV, all I saw was this constant reminder of these Eurocentric beauty standards that I would never be able to live up to. Imagine turning on your TV and all you ever see people who don't look like you. And it's not as if there aren't any good Black actors out there, because there are. There aren't enough available roles to them. And the roles that are available to them go to the same few token actors every time. And it's like, what am I supposed to do about that?
I completely agree with you, Susie. And how would some of our youth feel growing up watching no one that looks like them? But I'm struggling to understand how this reflects on morality, especially because this issue could be considered as opinion-based.
Well, how can we all stand in solidarity? How can we be one big family and love each other, love our neighbors just as much as we love ourselves with all of our differences? This issue isn't opinion-based, and the Catholic teachings show me that we are not being treated the way we should. We're supposed to be treated with respect and dignity and equality, and we're not being treated that way. And things will never change if everyone just ignores all these injustices and if we pretend as if they're not happening.
I see what you mean. Thank you for sharing. Amira, you've been quiet, Do you have any thoughts on technology's effect on the youth in this day and age?
Well, I think there's a huge transition from someone's self-esteem in their childhood to their adolescence due to technology. See, as a teen, societal pressures become worse. When you're a kid, you're less worried about what everyone thinks. But when you become an adult, you suddenly become aware of all the false messages you're surrounded by. Because teens can easily access technology and social media. And on social media, there are constant reminders of what the perfect version of a man or woman should look like. No one realizes how unrealistic these ads are, or that everyone just posts the best versions of themselves. Everything is just made to look way more glamorous than it is, and this can really take a toll on someone's self-esteem.
I agree. With these filters and editing apps, no one is their true self. Every human person is created in the image and likeness of God. Why must we create unrealistic images that make us feel useless insecurities?
Exactly. Technology also affects youth's morality. We're taught that human dignity can be protected if human decency is met to one another. And social media has been linked to narcissistic traits and cyberbullying. A majority of people will witness or experience cyberbullying in their life sometime. With the freedom of speech that comes with social media and this perceived invisibility, it can often be used irresponsibly. Everyone has the opportunity to say anything they'd like to one another, and this allows people to portray a different image of themselves online. This leads to a moral disengagement where people can act immorally online without being viewed as an immoral person offline.
Yeah.
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 I know who she is,
but we've never talked.
And you probably
never will.
Never will.
Because we have become
creatures who do not talk.
Instead, we stalk through stills of chosen moments.
The ugly ones have
slipped
through the cracks.
And we can only
imagine
the intimate ways each other move.
The turn of a head,
tucking hair behind ears
with two delicate fingers
trace the face of a friend
through a translucent screen and claw out any flaw they can find.
But can't we see? We are all flawed.
Flawed victims of this
never
ending social experiment
that in de facto have stunted our socialization.
In your hand,
a girl throws her head back,
laughing,
but her gaze does not land on the cause of her
happiness. Instead, it goes right past the lens,
through the glass,
and into a world we act like we know so well, when really we know
nothing.
Am I really willing to put my morals aside to simply meet social media's unrealistic beauty standards?
But the authentic product is way too expensive. There has to be something similar for a better price.
Clothing worth the negative effects it produces on the earth and society? Is a jacket that could easily go out of style within a few months worth compromising my morals?
It is a harsh but well-known fact that fast fashion is an unethical way of producing clothing and accessories. The unjust, unseemly, degrading treatment of workers, where large companies treat people like machinery to keep their merchandise prices low, simply cannot be justified.
Supporting a company that exploits workers to quickly produce the latest trend shoved down my throat by social media is unethical and would contradict my moral values. But will anyone think I'm pretty if I don't keep up?
There are dehumanizing circumstances for workers who are forced to accept low wages, no benefits, and dangerous working conditions just to make ends meet for themselves and their families.
Did you know that more than 1,800 workers of the fast fashion industry died between 2005 and 2013, and just in Bangladesh? Is the low cost of clothes equal to the cost of a life? Maybe I could just save up my money towards buying sustainable clothing, even if it means I'll have to wait to get that perfect Instagram photo.
We should not be led by social media to support corporations that violate the dignity of work and the dignity of life and the human person. Two of the seven Catholic social teachings based on which we may make ethical decisions in our everyday lives.
And what about the effect that supporting these brands has on the environment? Not only is the production of fast fashion items extremely polluting, but the industry in general creates a never-ending cycle of waste.
My clothes should last for many years. Clothing I could give to loved ones or donate to less fortunate if I no longer want to wear it. Clothing that doesn't fall apart or is of such poor quality that I cannot wear it when it arrives at my house.
Did you know that the fast fashion industry produces an amount of waste equivalent to 10,000 pieces of clothing being sent to a landfill every 5 minutes? Is that something I should be contributing to?
One of the Catholic social teachings, to care for God's creations, directly teaches us to avoid that. We must care for God's greatest and most precious creation, our planet. In no way is supporting fast fashion supporting sustainability to preserve Earth. God created a home for us, and we should do our part by boycotting businesses that directly tarnish it.
The people I see online being praised for their beauty as they were the internet's current fashion trends should not pressure me to conform my morals. And although it is indirect, act unethically by supporting these brands that do nothing but ruin our world and act against the Catholic social teachings.
But at the end of the day, I'll do anything to be good enough.